Oh, checky check. All right. Hey y'all, how's it going? We're back to it, but decided to come back to the old sea cliffs. I got some ideas on how to fix things and add some cool sounds, so here we go. Without further ado, I took that crackle off of the pad because of all the stuff that I was deliberately putting it through, the really cranked up compression and ducking, the ducking thing I was doing with the silent construction sites sounds. So it was giving too much of a mistakey sounding crackle, so I mixed it down just that track, and I bounced it back in, the old ping pong method, and EQ'd it away, EQ'd the crackling down to something that sounds better. Now, doesn't sound wrong. It just sounds timid and distant, like you're, like a mirage kind of sound. It's cool. I also put it through fromage to give it a kind of a whistling, like a sour whistling sound, which I might have to rein back a little. Okay, so that's how it sounds. So I think I want to add some sound effect things that I recorded and found, but this first thing is something I recorded. So the wash that's under here is a treated recording, a long treated recording of a thunderstorm. Not a very violent thunderstorm, but it's mostly what you hear is the city traffic sounds through my window. But it sounds good when it's kind of EQ'd back and gives this sort of felt but not directly heard wash in the background. But I want to add some other things to it. Okay, I'm gonna have to pull that back a bit, I think. Let's do that now while I'm thinking of it, before we hit it again and I go, I hate that part. Okay. Should be easy. That should do it. Okay, that sounds pretty nice. But I'm eager to play with these old, new old sounds that I dug up. Here's the first one. So I'm going to listen for bits. I think there are a couple of voices in here that I have to edit out. That's awesome. The rocks hitting the wood. That's what I think it is. That's cute. That's my wife saying, "Be careful, honey." Because I'm clumsy and I was holding the phone and the mic at the beach, and to get the right position, I had to plant myself between these two huge, what, breaker? But they're tetrapods. They're these really big, taller than me, kind of cement structures in the shape of tetrapods that are meant to break the waves. So I planted myself between two of these things and the and trying not to get wet, and so it blocks the wind, so I get mostly just the waves and the rocks. And she saw me kind of stumbling around, and she said, "Oh, be careful, honey." Good old me, son. But the frequencies of her voice don't really fit in with this piece, so sorry, you're gonna go. She's adorable. Okay, let's get. I think that's all right. It doesn't need to be perfect. I love that. Okay, that's the wave rolling in, crash, and then when the wave rolls out, it turns over these perfectly smooth pebbles, and it ha only happens at a certain time at night. Or in the evening, when the tide is coming in. Only then can you get the really good sounding rocks on that particular beach. And I waited a while just to hike out there, and we hiked out there to get this sound. And that's the sound I was looking for. If you can hear the kind of, you know, thousands of little rocks being clunked together a little bit, it's really cool. This is the bit right here. Okay, and there's her voice again. So luckily it happens one more time. So I have to edit this bit out. That's awesome. We're gonna put that in the beginning. Question is how much of this do I want in the very beginning before the music starts? Let's start with a lot and pull it back if needed. speaking levels. It's probably not as bad as it sounds to me in the headphones right now. It probably won't be that bad in the full final mix. But we're going to put a little limiter on there anyway. Alright, I want to see how the beach rock sound at the end, and then if that's okay, then I'll put in some other sounds. I consider this last phase kind of frosting on the cake, throwing in little bits here and there, things to kind of, you know, pepper the sound, you know, pepper the landscape with things. Paint a few happy trees, like Bob Ross would. Let's see how this swell turned out. Well, it's completely gone now, so I think I might take out that gain staging and just let the limiter do it. I'm always changing my mind about stuff like that. Yeah, the limiter isn't even triggering on that high note. It's just a weird harmonic. I think I'm finally getting the handle, getting a handle on the automation editing in MixBus. I'm so used to Cubase that I have to relearn how to do this for MixBus. But it's cool. I like it. I'm liking it more and more. I'm really slow at it. I was watching my friend, Mr. Square. I think his name is. I think his surname is Effington. I'm not sure, but he's an amazing, amazing composer for film and TV. And the way he just—I watch him do this streaming composing thing too. He's from Edinburgh, Edinburgh. So, I don't know, somewhere in Scotland, anyway. And the way he flies through Cubase is just mind-boggling. I just watch his hands. It's like watching a gamer. Like a shooter gamer, he just whoosh, if something needs to be done, it's like click 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 click, and he's done. You know, he's got it. He's just amazing at it. I'm kind of in awe, but yeah, someday I'll never be that fast, but one step at a time. Yeah, if it seems kind of empty here a little bit. That's perfect. Perfect swell. If it sounds empty around there, it's because I haven't added stuff yet. And the strings come in. I keep saying I'm gonna go back and listen to the beach again, but I always get sidetracked. Something weird there. Okay, I'll hit this later. Oh no. See, I want it to come in without people noticing it. I want to draw their attention away from the reintroduction of the beach sounds. And then go, oh, we're on this beach. Doesn't quite work, does it? Yep. I just kind of threw in the fader data willy-nilly, but so now I'll have to fix it. I heard some things that sounded cool, but I'll have to go back. Should I synchronize them? Try a couple things. Kind of ends too abruptly, doesn't it? Oh, that's why. I may regret this, but I'm going to take out that feedback automation. Didn't really do anything, did it? Yeah, I'm not so sure about that. I might have to come back to it later after some fresh ears. Come back to it later with some fresh ears. Mine. I have to be clearer when I speak. Okay, let's have a full listen through and see how badly I mess things up. Maybe I should make that fade out of the beach a little more gradual. Doing my old freeze the reverb trick. But I don't hear it. Okay, it did put a hiss on there. I hear it now. Let's have a listen again, see if it does anything. I think that's okay. hope those chirps in the left side don't cause too much trouble. I don't think they will. Sounds a little like Eno's Apollo, doesn't it? Okay, I think I'll add the other stuff some other time, but we'll see. But before I do that, I think I might lay on another recording of Beatrox to make it more stereo sounding. Because this is at the beginning. Sounds pretty flat and mono. It's too short. I can't do anything with it. And it doesn't even sound the same. Forget it. No, it's not a lesson. It's just me composing. How you doing, Nelson? You can join in the chat if you want. I am talking to you now, but join in the chat. I'll even switch to chat mode. For you, Nelson. Are you there, buddy? I don't know, maybe you can. I really hope that doesn't turn up in the mix. It's really annoying. It's probably just computer noise or data, whatever that means. Sounds terrible though. I think I'm just going to listen to it out and say goodnight after this, so about 3 minutes. Just going to let it ride. How you doing, the one extrovert? I hope that's not a wow of, wow, this sucks. Or is this Nelson? Are you Nelson? Give me a clue. Thanks. Okay, fair enough. Good to meet you. Shoegazy? Okay, I like shoegazy. Kind of navel-gazy, I guess. Yeah, it's really kind of low. Not many events per minute going on, so it's kind of stretched out. But I appreciate the listen. Caught me just at the end. I'm about to call it a night. It is almost exactly 10 minutes. Just a little bit more than 10 minutes. Yeah, like a lot of people, I guess, right? Among Us, it's huge. Even AOC plays it. Yeah, the ending kind of is wrong, so we'll fix that tomorrow. It's good to meet you. Maybe I'll see you in Among Us. But I'm probably more likely to play something like Skyrim or something. I'm a below average gamer. And I'm doing something now that doesn't really rack up the views. So I understand that. It's cool. Oh yeah, she just kind of gets in there and freaks out, right? Okay, I'm gonna head out and maybe I'll see you some other time. Follow me if you want, and cool. All right, I'll see you later. Appreciate it, man. Thank you.